So yeah, it's our last day of the whole trip, and I think it's time to reflect. That's why we're all. I asked the children what were their highs in during our trip. For me personally, I think I have three highs. The first one was the first country, one of the first countries, Fiji. The beautiful beaches, islands, weather, people. It was just amazing. The sea through blue. Everywhere, beautiful corals, fishes, it's really a big high. And the second one is that Tunis really wanted to go to India, and I was like, oh, India, I'm not sure, everybody will be sick and tummy bugs, and the children won't be able to handle it, and I don't know what. And I'm so happy we actually went to India. India was beautiful, we have seen so many amazing places. Beautiful people. It's such a different country. Everything is different. The women's fashion is different. Everybody walks in beautiful, colorful saris. The marriage system, you know, the arranged marriages everywhere. The whole country is very different from what we're used to in Europe. And then beautiful sights, you know, the Taj Mahal. It's gorgeous. And the Ajanta caves is just, I can't stop talking about those caves. It's really stunning. It's so old. And then Varanasi was just no words to describe it. It was really a holy place for Hindus, which for us was something I've never seen before. Washing in the Ganges, rinsing in the Ganges, everything just happened in the Ganges, river Ganges. Yeah, it was just very good to experience, and also for the children to see that. And the third high was that we've learned so many things about Asia, about the old Siam, which is in Thailand, Ayutthaya, the former capital, about the Red Khmer in Cambodia. Of course, all the beautiful temples, with the most beautiful temple was the Angkor Wat, definitely is one of the world wonders as well. I really like the fact that we've all learned a lot from all the trips we made, the sights we've seen.
I really liked the Angkor Wat and how everything was oversized and extra made extra dramatic, and it was beautiful. And it wasn't just one temple. No, it was a whole complex of temples. There were many temples. Each had a different style, and yeah, it was just so different to what we're used to. And how also that learning about the Red Khmer and how they ended so many lives of the Cambodian people, stole all the wealth.
Okay, team, what are we going to order?
Chocolate milkshake.
Uh-huh. How many? Wie bestelt het?
Nee.
Six?
Ja.
Five.
Okay, why is this a special day today?
Because today the world trip ends.
And if we are reflecting our trip, what was the best part?
Definitely the part where I was driving. We went in the outback and I was allowed to drive.
And you would?
My favorite part was definitely sandboarding in New Zealand.
Tunis?
There are many places that I would say are my favorite. One of them is the Grampians, where we climbed up Hollow Mountain with all the history of the Aboriginals that we learned there, and the drawings, the old paintings, I think you call them. It was beautiful, but there's many other places. It's hard to choose one. Fraser Island, for example. Fraser Island was really cool. Driving on the island on your own, nobody gives a care where you go. Super.
My favorite part was that we were also in the outback, and we went to a place where we could dig opal. It was so cool, and and then we saw a shop, and there we could buy opal, but we were also allowed to dig opal out in a very big pile of mud and with opal, and we sieved the opal out.
My favorite part was when we saw all animals and kangaroos jumping over the road and ostriches running into each other and other animals.
Platypus. That was apparently they're dangerous. They're toxic, poisonous. I think is the word. But they were really special little animals. Very nice.
And I also liked it here in Sri Lanka, where we got to meet all our friends again after all this time. It's so fun.
Also, when it was my birthday. We were in the middle of nowhere, and I got a cake, and I had no clue where I would get one, because where would you get a cake in the middle of nowhere? And I even got a camera, and that's what I really wanted. And then after, we went to the, I don't know where we went, but we went to a river where there were crocodiles, and we went canoeing in there. And that was so fun. It was so nice.
And didn't the crocodiles didn't eat you?
No.
Why not?
Because I think they were not salt water.
Very
they
good.
Not
fresh water crocodiles, they don't eat meat.
Yeah.
And you, did you?
We also went to somewhere where there were 7 waterfalls. And they said the 7th was the best, and the 6th or the 5th had a water slide. Like you climbed on the stone, and then you slid down on the stone. Very fun.
And I think I also enjoyed when we were in the Great Barrier Reef and we went snorkeling. It was like absolutely beautiful, and there was this huge fish that just came up and just. Well, you could literally stroke it and didn't really mind. It's super cool.
Also, here in Sri Lanka, we went surfing further down, and it was awesome. I haven't surfed since Australia, and the waves were perfect. Like, usually, waves, like, they go whoop straight over, but here they went. And then over, so you could like ride them really good.
What kind of board did you have?
pro board.
For the first time, huh?
I also enjoyed in Indonesia when Grandma came to find us. And then we went and we traveled for a month with Grandma. And she even went down down some slides with us, water slides. First she was really scared, but then it was absolutely awesome.
Talk about Indonesia. I was surprised that it had developed so little. There's all the rubbish everywhere. And we've seen it in other places after that. And coming now to Sri Lanka, where I lived 25 years ago, it was a really nice surprise to see how well they have developed. The roads are great, there's hardly any rubbish anywhere, the houses are a good quality, there's Wi-Fi everywhere, there's phone coverage everywhere, which I think is really nice to see. A good development.
I also lived in Kuala Lumpur when on my birthday we went to see some another group of friends from 5 years ago. It was like we spent a few days in the house before they got there, and then they came in, and then it was awesome to surprise them.
There was even a scorpion. He was on the staircase.
The first wild one I've ever seen in my life!
Having traveled for a year with the children, there's always reasons why not to travel with children, because you can get worried about anything. But now, having gone through it, it's actually no worries at all. As long as you're prepared and you take a bit of care where you eat and where you sleep and which things you can and can't do. And traveling Asia with children is really no issue at all, and I would advise everybody to do it.
And also by a different temple in the middle of the city, there were a lot of monkeys around, and you could go inside, look at all the monkeys trying to get inside, and we went making photos of all those monkeys, and there were babies, big, fat ones, and one jumped on Yan's hair. And grabbed his hair like a control stick. And one took Hannah's flower and started chewing on it like it was a real one. And then after, we went inside, and then a monkey jumped down with one leaf of the fake flower. And the flower had also a clip on it. And then a fatter monkey jumped down with nearly all of the rest of the flower. And one was chewing on the clip of the metal.
So, when we went camping, we slept under koalas, and they said, yeah, you can sleep under koalas. We were like, yeah, sure. And then we fell asleep. Like koala snores, like louder than pig snores, deeper than pig snores, and
pig snore.
Yes, louder. And every night, Mom and I woke up. It's every night, like five times. It's just crazy.
And then we woke up, climbed out of the tent, and indeed, high in the tree, there was this koala still sleeping, not snoring though.
And also, Hannah would not wake up, and I didn't either.
Yeah, you did, because I did this.
Yeah, only because you did that.
And then did you hear it?
Yeah.
It was very loud, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I didn't hear anything.
No.
I just kept sleeping.
Yeah.
Dad couldn't wake me.
Dad had to wake me because I just slept through it, but it was pretty cool and strange, really strange.
You might think koalas are very slow in the trees, but actually on the floor they run for their lives.
Have you seen them?
Yes.
Out of the trees? On the,
they
on
jumped the out of the trees, ran, jumped in a different one, climbed to the top, and started swimming.
I thought you were choosing a crab or a fish.